morning, everyone. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess, Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Pardon the faults of your servants, we pray, O Lord, that we, who cannot please you by our deeds, may be saved through the intercession of the Mother of your Son and our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Saving work of the Redeemer, salvation. Today's memorial, we look at this dedication of the Church of St. Mary Major. It's one of the major basilicas in Rome. The Holy Father likes to visit this basilica as he prays and asks the intercession of the Mother of God. When we look at a dedication of a church, and we speak about this often, we know that the church is just not a building. More importantly, it's the living stones which house what we understand as the church, you and me. And it's always important to understand we are the living stones. We're baptized and redeemed by the blood of the Lamb that was sacrificed for our salvation upon the altar of the cross. And we gather around the altar of the cross as this Lamb of God was sacrificed for you and for me and for our salvation. And what's so beautiful about it is we go back to the moment. It happens in time so that you and I may have the saving graces of that one moment. But as Catholic Christians, we don't repeat what has already been done. What has been done has been done. Christ died once. That's it. He died and he rose from the dead for our salvation. And what's so beautiful about the Mass is we go to that point of his death, that kairotic time that we speak about. So let us understand that that time has been, of course, suspended, and we go to that moment, dive into that mystery. I guess when we think about it, we think about the awesomeness of just the celebration of Holy Mass and what it affords you and me, that gift of salvation. People may say, well, I wasn't there at 33 AD. I wasn't there right by Mount Calvary where he died. Why wasn't there at the Last Supper or at the Resurrection? Yes, you are. It's happening now. See, time cannot hold God back. Time and space is free that God can do his work and bring it to every place, people, and culture. And they may experience it in sacramental signs which Christ is working and doing in us. When we celebrate a dedication of a church or a basilica, we're reminding ourselves that there also is only one church. Christ has founded only one church for our salvation. It would be hypocrisy if we were to say he founded a plethora of churches. And also, as you and I know, if there's more than one church, then the whole concept of church as capital C is diminished. We don't even know how to define it anymore. Because when someone asked you, what is the church? How could we respond to that? I'm not talking about the small C church in which you and I are sitting in right now. I'm talking about what is the church capital C? Well, if there's many of them, what kind of voice is the church speaking? This voice, that voice, this voice, that voice. There's only one church. In fact, there's four marks to the church, aren't there? I mean, Remember when we were in school, we were taught the four marks of the church, right? One, and there you have it, holy, Catholic, and apostolic. That really defines the church as the one voice. As soon as somebody breaks away from the church and starts their own ecclesial community, they can't have the name church anymore, because it takes away from the unity in which Christ has established. I know that you and I don't think of that often, but that's what we believe. That's what we understand. And even though we ride by and we see many different buildings that says church, technically that's not true. There's only one. There's only one church. Like there's only one God. Like there's only one Mass. Like there's only one priest. There's also only one church. And so when we look at a dedication of the church, we understand the mission of Christ and why he established it. So this church was dedicated back in 1984 by Cardinal Pole. And it is here as an edifice of everything that Christ is and teaches for the salvation of souls. So it's more than just a building. It houses the people of God who have been redeemed and saved. It houses the salvation of the world. That is Christ and his salvific cross and glorious resurrection. It houses the proclamation of the word and the celebration of the sacraments. It's a place in where people are forgiven their sins, where couples are united in marriage, where prayers are offered for the dead and their soul joined to God. It's more than just a building. That's why we call it the house of God. So as we celebrate the dedication of this church, St. Mary Major in Rome, one of the major basilicas in Rome, may we really understand the definition of church, papacy, and understand what that means, so that it's never weakened, it's never misunderstood, it's never confused, but it stands strong as a sign of Christ's gift to all of us. You are Peter, and upon this church, not many others, this one, the gates of hell will never prevail against it. After reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For the Holy Church and its mission to build God's kingdom on earth, may Christ's glory shine in her. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of those who hold elected office, may they be led by the gospel in the development of policies. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of those who hunger or thirst, may God satisfy their every need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us called to witness to Christ's glory, may God increase our understanding to do his will. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they soon find their place at the table of Christ's heavenly feast. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Sean Perrin, Jacob Curtis, Suzanne and Tom DeSantis, Grace Jimeno, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Virginia Jenikova, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, that all of us may further the mission. us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially from members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us pray for the seminarians and their formators who will be coming to us this evening. Let us pray for their perseverance and that they may continually hear the voice of Christ calling them, and that it is God's holy will to the priesthood. May God bring to completion in their life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they are in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, and through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, and through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, the work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the call of his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we ask, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that through the intercession of Blessed Mary, the mother of your Son, no petition may go unanswered, no request be made in vain. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on this memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived her only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions and glory, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven, and the blessed seraphim, worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are holy indeed, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by the divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil."
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Blessed is the womb of the Virgin Mary, which bore the Son of the Eternal Father.
Blessed
body. The body. The body.
Thanks be to God.
Have a nice day, everybody.
Thank you.
Say, Michael.
We are here.